celebrates with patriotic fervor as the state celebrates the 61st Goa Revolution Day, commemorating its liberation from Portuguese colonial rule. The day was marked by a series of events and ceremonies across the state, honoring the courage and sacrifices of freedom fighters who played a pivotal role in securing Goa's liberation. Artists and stalwarts from the field of theatre, music, films and various other backgrounds have demanded the resignation of Art and Culture Minister Govind Gavde for the alleged wrongdoing in the Kala Academy renovation. Artists have warned of a big agitation if Kala Academy is not restored within 15 days to its original form. They have pledged to take the agitation to the streets to ensure action against the wrongdoings and to correct that has been already done to the Kala Academy. Father Simão Purificao Fernandes was ordained as Auxiliary Bishop of Goa and Daman at a solemn concelebrated Mass at the Sé Cathedral on Monday. He will be assisting Archbishop Felipe Neri Cardinal Feirão in his duties. Feirão was the main celebrant at the Mass where many bishops and priests from across India concelebrated. Newly consecrated Bishop Simão has chosen the motto to serve, not to be served. The faithful from all parishes in Goa came to attend the solemn celebration. Consumers in for a shock as the state government has accepted the 3.5% tariff hike suggested by JERC. The new rates were made applicable from Sunday. The JERC said the new tariff is necessary to reduce the dependence of the electricity debt on government budgetary allocations. The energy charges have been hiked across the board for domestic, commercial, industry and agricultural consumers. This will cast a severe burden on the common man. After O Heraldo highlighted the theft of Olive Ridley turtle eggs, Forest Department sent a team to the spot to make an on-the-spot assessment. Despite 446 Olive Ridley turtles coming on the shore from Galgibaga in South Goa to Morji in North Goa to lay 24,564 eggs, red flags are being raised in the figures released by turtle guards in Morji. In a shocking revelation at the Morji nesting site, it has come to light that 7,869 eggs were laid, 5,435 hatchlings released, 334 eggs dead and 2,095 were reported to have been stolen. Of the 446 turtles, 230 turtles visited Galgibaga and 216 turtles came to Morji. Minister of State for Power and New Renewable Energy and North Goa MP Shripad Naik said that projects like Tamnar are essential for the development of the state. Naik even said that some environmentalists are against it, but it is possible to do this project, even while maintaining the environment. A meeting will soon be held with the Goa government regarding this, he informed. Monsoon clouds gather over Goa, domestic tourists are still flocking to experience the unique charm this season offers. Known for its beaches and lively atmosphere, Goa transforms into a lush green heaven during the rains, attracting visitors seeking a different side of the popular destination. In this edition of Street Voices, Herald TV spoke to tourists as to why they like to visit Goa even in the monsoons. Do they face any problems with taxi travel? Do they find the hotel tariffs high? Reacting to the Herald and Herald TV story on 16 June relating to the nagging traffic congestion, DGP and SP Traffic have taken initiatives which may help to solve the traffic jam near schools in Margao. A meeting of top concerned officials has been slated in Margao on Tuesday to solve the imbroglio. Meanwhile, elaborate traffic arrangement will be made during school hours from Tuesday to handle traffic congestion outside schools. 15 people were killed and at least 60 injured when the Sialdah-bound Kanchenjunga Express collided with a goods train near New Jalpaiguri Station in West Bengal. The collision occurred near Rangpani Station, approximately 7 km from New Jalpaiguri, causing the rear compartments to derail. Ekwutta has submitted formal request to the Agasaim police station for a thorough investigation into the recent infant remains found at Tari Vadomandur. expressing deep distress over the recurring incidents of infants being abandoned and left to perish. Balancho Equot has voiced its dismay at what they perceive as a lapse in societal and governmental responsibility. Of Duswa resonated with joyous hymns and fervent prayers as hundreds of devotees gathered at St. Anthony Chapel to celebrate the feast of St. Anthony on Sunday. At the heart of the celebration was a cherished relic, a fragment of the miraculous tongue of St. Anthony, believed to have been brought all the way from the Cathedral of St. Padua in Italy. This sacred artifact continues to inspire deep reverence among the faithful in Duswa. Several religious sites on Monday were thronged by the devout who gathered to offer namaz on the auspicious occasion of the holy Eid al-Adha festival. Eid al-Adha, also known as Bakrid, is a significant celebration for Muslims globally. When Eid is observed depends on moon sighting, typically starting first in Gulf regions and later in South Asia. In 2024, it starts on Sunday, 16th June, marking a day of sacrifice and redemption. A thrilling encounter at the St. John D. Baptista Ground, Benolim, Parish Youth Nuwem edged past Kandoli SC 1-0 to advance into the semi-finals of the 13th Kanna Benolim Panchayat Cup Intervillage Football Tournament. The match started with Kandoli SC displaying early nerves, particularly evident in their defense, which Parish Youth Nuwem capitalized on. In a scintillating display of football prowess, striker Clencho Pinto led Don Bosco Oratory Fatoda to a resounding 6-1 victory over Varka Sports Club, securing their spot in the semifinals of the 13th Kanna Benolim Panchayat Cup football tournament. The match, organized by UC Benolim and hosted at St. John D. Baptista Ground, witnessed an outstanding performance from Pintu, who netted a brilliant hat-trick. Kuturi defeated SSVO Nerul 3-0 and moved into the next round of the Piyush Armbol Football Cup 2024 at Mount Carmel Church Ground Armbol Monday. Bhai Kuturi netted a goal each through Angel, Clifton and Roizen.